In this segment, we'll talk about the bisection method. We'll talk about the algorithm of how to find the root of a nonlinear equation by this particular method. So in the previous lesson, we talked about that how if there is a real and a continuous function in the equation f of x equal to 0, so if we plot this particular function f of x as a function of x, and we are able to find 2 points so that the function is changing sign, then we can guarantee that there is at least one root between x l and x u. Of course, the function has to be real and it has to be continuous between those 2 points. So what we have basically done is that we have bracketed the root between x l and x u. So how does that help us so far as the bisection method is concerned? Is that what we're going to do is we're going to say, hey, let me choose the midpoint between x l and x u. So let's suppose it's right here. So if that is the midpoint, so let's suppose I call that to be xm 1, let's suppose, because it's the first iterative value. So I get this as my root. Now what I got to figure out is that, hey, I can start with two brackets now. I can start with this bracket and this bracket. And I'll have to now see that, hey, which bracket does the root fall in? And if I apply the same principle of that, hey, is the function changing sign, I'll find out, hey, yeah, the function is changing sign between the first bracket and not in the second bracket for this particular case. So what I've basically done is that I have created a new lower limit and a new upper limit for my interval in which the root is occurring. And I can continue this process again. I can say, okay, the midpoint is right here. And then I have to decide whether it is in this bracket or whether it's in this bracket. And you'll find out, hey, it will be in this bracket right here that the root will be existing. And you continue this process of finding the midpoints in these brackets. And that's how you'll be able to find out what the root of the equation is. And of course, what you're going to do is you are going to compare. So let's suppose you have a new midpoint, which you have found out by doing this, and you have an old midpoint, and you're going to compare it with the previous one, which you have found out, and you multiply by 100, and that gives you the absolute relative approximate error. So based on this, what you can do is you can compare it with the pre-specified tolerance, which might be given in terms of a percentage or in terms of number of significant digits I want to be correct in my answer. And that's how you will develop this algorithm. Or of course, you will also have an upper limit on the number of iterations you want to go through, because it's quite possible that it might take, it might converge slowly. In fact, bisection method does converge generally slowly. But one of the good things about bisection method is that it converges, its convergence is guaranteed, because you already bracketed the root. The only thing which you have to wait for is that how fast it is going to zero in on the root of the equation. So let's go, and what we'll do is we'll write the algorithm for the bisection method. Okay, so the algorithm for the bisection method will be first as follows. What we got to do is choose 2 points, xl and xu, such that the value of the function at the lower limit times the value of the function upper limit is less than 0. So we're starting with trying to find the root of the equation f of x equals 0. That's our goal, to find the root of that equation. So we're going to choose xl and xu such that the function is changing sign. And of course, we are given that it is real and continuous, of course, between those 2 points. Keep in mind that if somebody gives you these two limits of the or bracket of the root here, keep in mind that you should always check whether it's a valid bracket or not. Many times students will not check whether it's a valid bracket or not. Then what you're going to do is you are going to estimate the root. And the estimate of the root would be that, hey, xm is equal to xl plus xu divided by 2. And then how you're estimating the root is the midpoint. And that's how you would find the midpoint in the of those 2 points. Now what you have to do is, you, in order to figure out, hey, if this is XL and this is XU and this is my XM, what I have decided is this my this my new bracket or is this my new bracket? I have to choose between one and two bracket. So I have a bracket which is XU minus XL length now, and I'm basically making the bracket to be half of, so far as the width is concerned, half of what it was before. So how do I make that determination is by checking. I will check if the value of the function XL times the XM is less than zero. If that is so, then root is between XL and XM, because the function is changing sign between these two points. So what that would mean is that I will make my lower limit to be the same XL, and I'll change my upper limit to the midpoint now. Now, we also will check if the value of the function at XL times XM is greater than zero. Then we know that the root is between XM and XU, because surely it's not between XL and XM because the function isn't changing sign. So it has to be between XM and XU. And if that is the case, then my lower limit will become my midpoint, and my upper limit is going to stay the same. It is also possible by chance that the value of the function at the lower limit times the value of the function at the upper limit will turn out to be exactly equal to zero. There's a very small chance. Then we already know that we have already got the root, and the root will be equal to XM. And we will, of course, in this case, what we'll do is we will stop the process, or stop the algorithm. So let's go and see what we're going to do next. So what I'm going to do next is, now that since I've updated my lower and upper limit, I will find a new midpoint, which will be given by this. And what I have to do is I have to check whether it is within a pre-specified tolerance. So I will calculate the absolute relative approximator, which is the new midpoint minus the old midpoint divided by the new midpoint, and I'll multiply by 100. So this is from the previous iteration. This is from the current iteration. So you can call old to be previous and new to be current. That's the same thing. And then what you're going to do is you're going to check if epsilon A is less than epsilon S, where epsilon S is nothing but whatever we have pre-specified as our tolerance. So if this is true, then we stop, else we go back to step three, where we are going to again check, hey, is the function changing sign between XL and XM, or between XM and XU? Or we also going to also stop if maximum iterations have been used, because bisection method is known to be a slowly converging method. So we got to be careful about maybe not allowing it to have as many iterations as it needs. So you may have to stop if maximum iterations have been used. In that case, of course, if the maximum number of iterations have been used, then you have to tell the user that you have used the maximum number of iterations and not giving them false hope that you have achieved the pre-specified tolerance. And that is the end of the segment here.